Hey, what's up guys? Today I'll show you a mystery thriller film, Solace. Spoiler ahead, watch out and take care. The movie begins where a dead bald man is lying on his chair, with his eyes wide open. The man appears to finally find his solace. The detectives led by Mr. Mustache and Beauty, arrive at the crime scene to investigate. They figure out that the man died from a single blow in the back of his head, which is a similar method used in the preceding murder cases in the town. The murder cases are done by a meticulous method, and leave no trace from the crime scene. They then conclude that the murderer is a serial killer, who is trying to find his next victim. The detective appears to be hopeless, since they cannot find a single clue that will lead them to the killer. In desperation, Mr. Mustache decides to seek help from his old psychic friend, called Uncle Psychic, who is a doctor and has the capacity to have a vision of the past and the future. Beauty is skeptical of Uncle Psychic's ability, but Mr. Mustache seems to fully trust him, since Uncle Psychic appears to help the detectives on solving criminal cases in the past. So the following day, he proceeds to drive with her towards Uncle Psychic's home in the mountains. It turns out that Uncle Psychic decides to live in the mountains after the death of his daughter, who died of leukemia 2 years ago. The tragic death of his daughter also led him to break up with his wife. They soon arrive at Uncle Psychic's house to convince him to help them solve the murder case. But Uncle Psychic is reluctant to help them, as he wants to live in peace. As Beauty comes to give him the file case, she gives him a light tap. Her touch suddenly gives him a vague vision of her death. As Uncle Psychic decisively refuses to help them, they finally leave his house. Later, Uncle Psychic is peacefully reminiscing his vision about his daughter. In his vision, his young daughter is playing around wearing a pink costume. He also has a vision of his teenage daughter screaming in pain, and a vision of her happily laughing. In a few moments, he comes to check the file case, where a line was written by the killer suddenly intrigues him. Coincidentally, the line turns out to be from the music which he is listening to at that moment. He then walks outside, where he gains a vision of a strange man looking at him. The strange man seems to be the killer. The coincidence of the line and the vision of a strange man greatly intrigues him, so he finally decides to help the detectives to catch the serial killer. The following day, Uncle Psychic comes to the city to have a briefing about the case. In the briefing, Beauty reveals the consistency of the killer's murder method. As he comes to hold the case photo, he gains a vague vision of the child eating ice cream right before being murdered. After that, they bring Uncle Psychic towards the crime scene of the first murder victim. But upon inspecting the first crime scene, Uncle Psychic fails to find anything. Uncle Psychic just jokingly says that the woman likes wearing a hat. After that, Uncle Psychic and Mr. Mustache come to eat in a food stall on the rainy streets. As Mr. Mustache gives him a light tap, he suddenly gains a vision of Mr. Mustache dying in the hospital. At that moment, he seems to be concerned, but he keeps it a secret from Mr. Mustache. Later, as he is walking towards his room, he keeps having a strange vision that seems to be related to the killer. He keeps having a vision of the word Atticus and a running train. In his sleep, he gains a vision of a drowning beautiful woman asking for help. He then wakes up, receiving a call from the detectives. It turns out that the detectives find another murder victim. As they arrive at the crime scene, they find a note with the number 416, which turns out to be the time of their arrival at the crime scene. The note implies that the killer knows they will arrive exactly at that time. Shortly after, Uncle Psychic comes to check the victim, who turns out to be the beautiful woman from his vision. He touches the victim, and he magically sees the events leading to her death. He sees that the woman lays in the bathtub, thinking that her husband prepares it for her. As the woman is enjoying the moment, the killer then instantly pierces the back of her head, leading to her quick death. Meanwhile, the detectives speculate that the killer might be her husband. So they come to the headquarters to interrogate the husband, while Uncle Psychic listens on the side. The husband tells them that he has already left the murdered woman for another woman. The husband then left a letter for the murdered woman, but Uncle Psychic knows that the husband is not telling the whole story, since he already has the vision of the whole story by touching the husband's writing pen. Uncle Psychic then reveals that the husband left the woman for another man. The husband also appears to be infected by HIV. The husband then knows that telling the woman about his sexuality and his disease would leave great damage to the woman, since the woman appears to be emotionally unstable. After that, Uncle Psychic and Mr. Mustache proceed to eat their breakfast in Mr. Mustache's home. Apparently, Mr. Mustache leaves happily with his family. As they eat breakfast together, Uncle Psychic reveals that the murder victims appear to be severely ill, except the child. It appears that the serial killer targets those people who are suffering from chronic illnesses. To confirm Uncle Psychic's speculation, they need to examine the child victim's body to check if the child has an illness. So Uncle Psychic and Beauty drive towards the child's family to convince them to examine the child. Along the way, Beauty asks Uncle Psychic about his ability. He then says that his ability is not mystical or supernatural, but only a more powerful version of human intuition. Shortly after, they finally arrive at the child victim's home. The mother is reluctant to agree to examine the child's body because of religious beliefs. It seems that she only believes in God's plan. But Uncle Psychic convinces her by telling the story about his daughter, who died from leukemia. He says that medical procedures would not alter God's plan, but it would help them solve the mystery behind the murderous event. The mother then finally gives them permission to examine the child's body. So later at the lab, they conduct an autopsy on the child's body. At that moment, Uncle Psychic receives a message from the killer, telling him to check the brain of the child. As the doctor checks the brain of the child, the doctor finds a small tumor hidden in the brain. This confirms Uncle Psychic's speculation that the killer targets only the people with chronic illness. At the same time, Uncle Psychic figures out that the killer also has the capacity to see the future. The killer appears to know their actions ahead of them. So Uncle Psychic decides to leave the case, knowing that they are walking towards a trap set by the killer. Later, Beauty comes to Uncle Psychic to express her resentment at his decision to leave the case. Uncle Psychic then declares that it is completely useless to catch the killer, since the killer murdered the victims as an act of kindness. The killer murders the victims to save them from the pain that they would suffer from their illnesses. Uncle Psychic suddenly falls into silence as Beauty asks him what he would do if the victim turned out to be her daughter. Beauty then bugs him about the things he knows. So he reveals Beauty's painful past. Apparently, she has a child, but she gives up the child to the adoption center. Beauty then tearfully forces Uncle Psychic to tell her more, but he refuses to reveal that Ms. Beauty would be shot by the killer. The following day, Mr. Mustache and the police officers raid the killer's apartment, thinking that the killer is there, but it appears to be a false alarm, since they only find a mutilated body of a man. The scene inside the apartment appears to be horrifying, where body parts are scattered, and a top half-dress is hanging on the wall. Mr. Mustache appears to be hopeless about the case, so he chases Uncle Psychic, who is about to go home that day. Uncle Psychic is also having a vision of flowers and frogs, which appears to be related to the case. At the same time, he also sees nuns singing a prayer, while Mr. Mustache is screaming in pain in his visions. Mr. Mustache arrives and asks him to help them again as a personal favor. He then agrees to join them again in the case. After that, Mr. Mustache brings him towards the location of their new clue. Apparently, the detectives find a snail poison on the murdered woman's bathwater. The poison can be found on a specific flower found in the park. So Mr. Mustache brings him there. He touches the flower and sees a garbage can in the middle of the flower field. The detectives then search the garbage can and find the lower half of the dress from earlier. They then let the police dog sniff the dress so they can trace the person who puts it there. After the dog sniffs the dress, it leads them towards a studio room. But they find nothing there. A young man holding a frog mug walks out of the opposite studio room. The scene appears to be already seen by Uncle Psychic from his visions. The young man instantly shoots Mr. Mustache and immediately escapes out of there. As Uncle Psychic and Beauty walk out of the apartment, the young man is already gone. So Uncle Psychic and Ms. Beauty ride a car to chase the young man. Uncle Psychic uses his ability to trace the young man's location. As they finally locate the young man, the scene turns into an intense car chase. With the help of Uncle Psychic's ability, they soon catch the young man. Uncle Psychic suddenly gets a vision that the young man would shoot him, so he hides behind the car and allows Beauty to shoot the young man. This makes Uncle Psychic realize that the young man is not the killer, since the young man is not able to predict getting shot by her. After that, Uncle Psychic comes to visit Mr. Mustache in the hospital. It turns out that Mr. Mustache is already suffering from stage 4 cancer and is about to die. He then instructs Uncle Psychic to take care of his family after his death. Later, Uncle Psychic reveals to Beauty the appearance of his vision about his daughter's death. It turns out that he saw a shadow surrounding his daughter during her childhood. As his daughter became a teenager, the vision finally manifested, and his daughter died from leukemia. The following day, the church conducts a funeral ceremony for Mr. Mustache, who just died from cancer. Uncle Psychic feels relief upon knowing that Mr. Mustache's son would live a good life in the future. At that moment, he sees his visions about Mr. Mustache happening, as he sees nuns singing prayers. Later at night, he goes to have some drinks in the bar to mourn for Mr. Mustache's death. There, the killer suddenly reveals itself to him. The killer then explains to Uncle Psychic that his murderous acts are in favor of the murder victims, since he sees the victims begging to end their pain in the future. The murder acts are not pleasurable for him. On the contrary, it is really hard for him to murder them, but he needs to do it as a favor for the victim. He then says that the greatest acts of love are the hardest acts to commit. Meanwhile, Uncle Psychic takes a look at the future to check if he can let the police catch the killer. But it turns out that the killer already figures out that he can escape safely from all the possibilities. Uncle Psychic suddenly smashes the killer's head, but the killer instantly informs the police that Uncle Psychic has a gun. The police then catch Uncle Psychic, instead of catching the killer, who instantly escapes. The following day, Beauty and the police forces finally know the appearance of the killer, as the waitress from the bar reveals it. She also tells the detective to trace the identity of the killer, from the chronically ill murdered victims in the country. Meanwhile, Uncle Psychic is concentrating on his visions to trace the location of the killer. In a few moments, he gains a vision of someone injecting poison on champagne. Shortly after, a chronically ill rich man finds champagne on his table and drinks it. The rich man feels dizzy, and the killer reveals itself to murder the rich man. To the killer's surprise, Uncle Psychic is sitting there to prevent him from murdering the rich man. The killer decides to back off and escapes from there. Uncle Psychic then chases him. Meanwhile, Beauty finally traces the real identity of the killer. She then comes to raid the killer's apartment, together with the police officers. But it turns out that the killer already predicts her arrival in the apartment, as a video of the killer awaits her there. The killer explains to her that he is not a psychopath or an antisocial. He is just a normal guy who decides to respond to other people's pain. At this moment, Uncle Psychic is chasing the killer on the streets. He passes through a hospital and recalls his daughter screaming from pain. Meanwhile, the killer tells a loser cop on the streets to report his location to the cop's supervisor. Beauty and the police officers then receive the report. This makes her rush towards the location. The killer rides the train, and Uncle Psychic also follows him there. The killer shoots his gun, making the people run away from the train, which leaves him alone with Uncle Psychic on the train. Shortly after, the train leaves the station and heads towards the next station. The police officers are preparing to confront the killer in the next station. The captain tells Beauty not to respond to the situation, since the police officers have everything in control, but Beauty is stubborn and proceeds to go there. Meanwhile, on the train, the killer reveals that Uncle Psychic would kill him at their arrival at the next station. It turns out that the killer is also dying from an illness, so he needs Uncle Psychic to kill him. Uncle Psychic then gains a vision that the killer would shoot Beauty on the next station. So this serves as a driving force for Uncle Psychic to shoot the killer. As they finally arrive at the next station, Uncle Psychic sees that his visions are slowly becoming real. Left without a choice, Uncle Psychic shoots the killer to save Beauty from getting killed. In the end, Beauty ends up safe, while Uncle Psychic suffers from minor injuries. The movie ends where Uncle Psychic finally reunites with his wife. He then recalls the moment before their daughter died. Apparently, Uncle Psychic euthanized their daughter to end her suffering from pain due to leukemia. It is a difficult decision for Uncle Psychic, but he knows it is necessary for his daughter. This gives sense to the killer's line that the greatest acts of love are the hardest acts to commit. This is Daniel CC Movie Channel. Peace out.